Greetings and welcome to the Anatomy of an ASA Article Citation. In this tutorial, we're going to briefly introduce ASA Style Citation and provide you with a basic example of the bibliographic citation of an article in that style, which we will then dissect, describing each of the constituent parts of that citation, why they're included, and how to format them in the citation. Hopefully, at the end of this video, you will understand the basic principles of citing an article in ASA style, and you will be able to construct your own basic article citations. To start out with, what is ASA citation? The ASA citation style is laid out in the ASA style guide, which follows the standards adopted by the American Sociological Association, hence the acronym. This citation style is used most commonly by programs in the social sciences, such as sociology and criminology. As of 2022, the ASA Style Guide is in its 7th edition, so the version of ASA Citation we will be covering in this video is ASA 7th. Okay, so now we know what ASA Citation is, how do we create one? Well, this is where we get into the gory details of dissecting a bibliographic citation to show you how it works. However, to really get the most out of this part of the video, it helps if you have the proper tools. At the very least, a paper and pencil, or pen, and maybe some highlighters if you think they would help. Feel free to pause the video now and collect your tools. Got everything? Great! Okay, so here you see the bibliographic citation we're going to dissect. And just in case you're wondering, no, I have not written an article titled The Book of Everything, a Hostile Review, for the non-existent Fictitious Reviews Quarterly. But this example will serve our purpose. Take your paper and write this citation exactly as you see it on your screen in the center of your piece of paper. Make sure to leave plenty of room for notes. Go ahead and pause the video while you write down the citation. Ready? Awesome. So now I'm going to take this citation apart piece by piece and describe each part, why it's there, and how it's formatted. As this is just a basic example, I may refer to some other situations you may come across while citing sources. If at any point you need more time to make notes about what I'm talking about, feel free to pause the video and then start again when ready. The first thing you should notice about this citation has to do with how a citation, that is multiple lines in length, is formatted. Every line after the first line is indented. This is what is called a hanging indent, and you can get Microsoft Word or Google Docs to format this part of your paper using this indentation style by going into the paragraph settings. So the first part of most citations will be the author's name. In ASA style, this is formatted last name, comma, first name, with a period at the end of the first initial. The reason to format citations last name first is structural. Your Works Cited page is organized alphabetically by author last name, hence it makes sense for it to be the first thing that pops out in a citation. But what happens if there's more than one author? Well, now it gets a little more complicated. The first author is formatted last name, comma, first name, comma, then you write the word and, followed by the second author's name, which is formatted first name, last name, followed by a period. So, assuming that I had written an article together with Barack Obama, because why not, this field would be formatted Heron, comma, Sean, comma, and Barack Obama, ending with a period. If there are three authors, you format the first two authors' names as before, but instead of using the word and between them, you put a comma there. Then you write the word and after the second author's name and write the third author's name in first name, last name format. So this would be Heron, comma, Sean, comma, Barack Obama, and Taylor Swift. Okay, and in all cases, always end with a period. After the author name comes the year of publication, which is followed by a period. We include the date after the author name in ASA citation because both of these elements are used to link the citations in the bibliography with the in-text citations in your paper. The next element in the citation is the article title. The reason we include the title of the article should be pretty clear. It's the specific work by this author that we're citing. In ASA citation, article titles are placed in quotation marks and are capitalized exactly as you find it done on the article itself. Once again, end with a period. The next element in the citation is the journal title. This is also capitalized exactly as it is found on the journal itself, but it is italicized to distinguish it from the earlier article title. There is no punctuation placed after the journal title. The next element in an article citation tells you where in that journal you will find the article. Standard format is that the volume number is followed by the issue number in parentheses. If the journal in question does not have issues, just volumes, you omit the parentheses. However, while this is of course standard, not all journals are organized by volumes and issues. Some journals, like our made-up fictitious reviews quarterly, are published four times a year, so the issue may just be fall 2015. If this is the case, don't freak out and try to find or invent volume and issue numbers that don't exist. Just record what the article says about its publication. Then you include the final element of the journal information, the page range in which you find the article. There is no space between the volume issue number and the page range in ASA. The page range is preceded by a colon and then followed by a period. This whole section of the citation from the journal title to the page range is a remnant from the time when libraries received all of their journals in print. During this time, you would look up an article in an index, an early form of database with no full text, and then look up the journal it came from in the library catalog. Then you would go down to the stacks and pull the bound volume, open it up to the issue in question, and then find your article on the page range specified. Databases make this a lot easier now. The last part of an article citation has to do with finding it online. This element is the DOI, which is like a permanent URL, which ensures that this article should be accessible from this point for the foreseeable future. If the article has no DOI, it may be omitted. That takes care of the bibliographic citation. But the bibliographic citation is only one half of a complete ASA citation. Every ASA citation has two parts, the bibliographic citation and the in-text citation. Why do you need both? Well, the bibliographic citation helps your reader know what article you got the information from, but doesn't tell the reader what part of your work was taken from that article, nor does it tell the reader where in the article you cited you got that idea or quote. To learn more about in-text citations, check out our tutorial on in-text citations, ASA style. Now, obviously, there are a lot more types of sources to cite than just articles, and there are a lot more situations for citing articles than we've covered in this brief video. If this video didn't answer your question, there are more resources available to help you cite your work. The Purdue Online Writing Lab, or OWL for short, provides an excellent website covering a lot of different scenarios and rules for ASA citation. To access the OWL, simply type in Purdue OWL ASA into Google or the search engine of your choice. Finally, you can always contact a librarian for citation assistance. You can email us at libraryhelp@cpp.edu or call the reference desk at 909-869-3084. Thank you for watching.